They were robbed of their lives by a terrorist who wanted to kill as many people as he could, who targeted them deliberately and indiscriminately, running some of them down in his car. Khalid Massoud's attack lasted less than 2 minutes. PC Keith Palmer was his fifth and final victim. After crashing his car outside, Massoud ran in and stabbed the unarmed officer to death at the gates of Parliament, where he'd been standing guard. He only had CS spray and a baton to protect himself. Today, the coroner concluded he could have been saved had armed officers been stationed at those gates. That, he said, was down to shortcomings in security, which meant no firearms officer had been anywhere near them for nearly an hour before the attack. Responding to those findings, PC Palmer's widow, Michelle, said in a statement, "How could Keith have been left alone, unarmed, guarding an open gate at one of the most iconic buildings in the world and one of the country's top terrorist targets?" She added, "I truly believe that if they, armed officers, had been there, he would still be here today and Amy wouldn't have lost her daddy." Today, the Assistant Commissioner of the Metropolitan Police apologised.
"The Chief Coroner has plainly carried out a rigorous and full inquiry, and we unreservedly accept his conclusions. Even the possibility that the Met lost the chance to prevent the murder of such a brave and courageous officer is unacceptable. For the loss of that possibility to protect him from Khalid Massoud, we are deeply sorry."
American tourist Melissa Cochrane and her husband Kurt had only been in London for 2.5 hours before Massoud deliberately drove into them. Mr. Cochrane managed to push his wife out of the way, almost certainly saving her life.
"Basically sacrificed his life for mine. Kurt would have done that for anyone, honestly. The fact that it was me, as I was standing next to him, but if it had been you or a complete stranger, Kurt was just that kind of guy, you know. He was selfless and just super kind. He was compassionate and loved people, which was, you know, obviously one of the reasons I loved him so much."
Massoud stole their lives, leaving their families with a lifetime of grief and questions, too, over whether their deaths could have been prevented.